When I first looked at this, I thought that there was some stuff that was missing. So obviously what that tells me is it's going to be a sprint. 30 overhead squats at 95 pounds, and then 7 muscle-ups, and then 20 overhead squats at 95 pounds, and finishing up with 5 muscle-ups. 4 time, as fast as you can. The weight's not real heavy, 95 pounds. I'm gonna wanna keep everything unbroken as much as I can. Hopefully not being too smoked out so that I can go unbroken on the muscle-ups. Being fast but being consistent is the name of the game for this one. It's a sprint. What I'm looking for on this is I want these guys, whatever client we have, to be able to get at least 20 reps is what I'm thinking. So they need to scale the weight appropriately to get that. When they're going down into position, we're obviously looking for that bar to be held out, locked out overhead. And we want the crease of the hip down below the top of the knee, all the way here, and then all the way up. What I have seen is if someone has a lot of shoulder flexibility issues, what I will do with that person is kind of bounce back and forth in their normal programming between going with weight and going with depth. If there's a shoulder flexibility issue when they're going down and they're unable to keep that bar over their heels, I'll have them go a little bit wider. The trade-off with that is the wider you go, the more tweak it's going to put on your wrist, so that's going to kind of affect how much weight you're able to hold overhead. We'll start off with a power snatch and just get the bar up, lock out, and start from a good position here. Even with my a lot of our clients, if they're newer, I would have them do that anyway because we want to always talk about open hips, get that full range of motion, come up and open hips again. All right, so now we're on our gymnastic movement, the muscle-ups. The two ways to do this are going to be either the false grip, which is basically holding the ring where the ring is splitting the butt of your hand so that your wrist is over top of the ring when you start. Now, this makes the muscle-up easier. But the difficult part on here is making sure that your arms get locked out at the bottom. You'll see a lot of people, they start the muscle-ups like this. We need to make sure you come all the way down and turn out. Now, you don't have to hang there for a long time. It could be that, and you're ready to go. The other idea is going to be a standard grip, or an open grip, which is right here. What that's going to have you, force you to have to do is have a really big kip, pop your hips up real high so that you can get your wrist over top of the ring. False grip will look like this, right here. All the way into the dip position, lock out up top. The open grip will look more like this. Bigger kip to here, and then get yourself up top. Scales for that, or what I like to do here at the Inferno. Our first one is if the client has a ring dip, then we will adjust the height of the rings so they're a little bit lower. So we'll do what's called the jumping muscle up, right here. To this position, and then up. What I don't want to have people do is I don't want them to jump like this. They didn't learn anything on that. You can set up on a band. Again, put the band around your butt. Your hands are in the false grip right here, and you actually can use the bounce as your transition into the dip position right here. So again, elbows are close, hands are close to right here. Get yourself up on the ring dip, and then back down. So again, they're learning the movements, they're learning the transitions at every single height. If there's just no way on the rings at all, then we'll go to the classic, which would be the classic scaling, which would be pull-ups and either dips or pull-ups and push-ups is probably another better one. But this is gonna be fast, so I don't want a whole lot of moving around.
I like overhead squats. I like overhead squats. My GOAT is a movement into muscle-ups. I just don't want to break them, but I don't know. Try to stay in there. It doesn't always happen. Damn, one. Couldn't get one more. Oh, well. Good job.